This is a quick walk around. Welcome to Akihabara. So I'm going to take you on a walk. I'm going to go and look for a new HDMI capture card that I can use my DSLR with for my live streams. So the best place to come and look for that sort of stuff is the computer town in Tokyo, Akihabara. It's changed a lot over the years. This has always been my favorite part of Japan. And the main place you want to come, it isn't the big Yodobashi. It's easy, you can go to the big Yodobashi camera on the Showadori side, on the other side. Or you can go down the main road and you can get distracted by all the maid cafes and all the people handing out flyers that you can see all around at the moment. The real Akihabara, which is the way it's always been since I first got to Japan, are these back streets that are parallel to the main streets that are full of all these PC parts and junk shops and stuff like that. This is where you used to buy the parts to go and make your PCs. And for me, this has always been the heart and soul of Akihabara, where you come to. Everything else is kind of a distraction. It's true the culture's changed, especially the maid cafe thing has kind of come to take over. I guess I find that stuff as hard to relate to now as people used to find me coming here for PC parts. That's Akihabara right there. If you ever want to buy a memory card or just a cheap like Chinese made type knockoff product of some sort, super cheap, but everything there. That's always a good place to go to. That's a regular. I think they've got some of the cheapest memory card prices in Japan there. Even if you look them up on the internet, they show that. Tsukumon, I built one of my last PCs at Tsukumon with parts from this shop over here. All of these places are just filled with floors and floors of nothing but one particular type of part, just cases, or just motherboards or CPUs. And what I love about this place is that when you talk to the people who run into those shops, they can tell you anything about those parts and what you should be getting. I made my PC. I hope the wind isn't causing too much distraction there. So, and it's funny, it's this eclectic mess of kebabs, ramen, cafes, PC shops, junk shops. And it's just great, it's just a place. Of course, girls can come too, but let's face it, it's a place of boys to toys, you know. There's a big, Mandrake shop over here for manga and books. This is kind of a new addition. That's indeed are the maids handing out flyers. So as you can see, it's a beautiful day today. I think there's some kebab places up here. I'm going to go ahead and get one of those first. And you can see, I mean, everything here, from basically just kind of junk and throwaway stuff to actually there's some really hidden away, some really, really good stuff and good price here. They've got everything here. They've got everything from, you know, anime porn shops to to military supply shops, to furniture, to maid cafes, dodgy DVD places. All food that's really bad for you. That in itself has a certain charm. I must admit, I'm not used to seeing the maid worker crowd that used to be here. I'm sure they're looking at me like they look at most of the guys here. Kind of freaks and geeks, but this is a place, this is an entire city. It's bigger than central Auckland. For example, a million person city that I'm from, the business district of Auckland, is smaller than just this Akihabara district, within which you have nothing but stuff like this, just nothing but parts shops and PC shops and geek culture basically just spread out over this huge area. And have a look, I mean, you can see all the people walking around here at the moment. It's nothing but people who are actually as geeky or geekier than me, which is remarkable. This, you know, and this is what's great about Tokyo. All of these towns are like little tribal towns where you can come and everybody is just unified by having a shared hobby, the shared, you know, really focused interest in this place that they're in. Oh, and look, we have arrived at the kebab place that I was looking for. So I'm going to grab a kebab and we're going to keep walking. Well, you know how I said, don't be lazy and get a big camera.
the Yodobashi camera. As you can hear, that's what I'm going to have to do. So that is where I'm up to now. I just checked out the place where I built my PC. They didn't have the exact video cards that I wanted. I'll tell you what, let's go on the main street, shall we? I came down the back street here. So what they do on Sundays, and this is a Sunday today, is they actually shut off all the traffic on the main street. This was taken advantage of, unfortunately, a nutter who drove a car down here and ran over some people a few years ago. But generally speaking, it's beautiful. You want to see a street, this is basically a city. Nothing but electronics and PC stuff. Check this out. Every one of these buildings is nothing but an electronic store. This is only half the station. And this isn't even the best part. The best part is in the side streets back over there. So, you know, it's pretty awesome. If you're someone who's into just like electronics, this is pretty much just too much to process the cost. It's not necessarily the cheapest, although actually if you can find your way around, if you can use the internet and find where the discount shops are, which are mainly in the back streets, it is actually extremely cheap as well. This is a good shot that probably has what I'm after as well. I don't have a lot of time. So I'm going to go straight to that building over there. I don't know if you can make it out there, but Yodobashi, which is just got everything. There's just one building with everything. It's kind of sad in a way to see a big shop like that. You know, given that the shop is closed. You know, you don't want to mess around. I've got that one, this one right now. The kebab was awesome, by the way. Also, the other thing is that if you're traveling here as a tourist, this place is so popular with tourists now that a lot of the places here are duty free, at least the big places are duty free. You kind of miss out on the small discount shops and stuff like that. And it's another aspect of the weirdness here that, you know, at the same time, you've got half these shops. People don't speak a word of English and they wouldn't know how to deal with foreigners, but the place is so popular with foreigners. Also, just coming back to the station now, there's a Gundam cafe over there and the AKB48 cafe, which definitely is not my thing. But it is for a lot of people. You can actually go and watch AKB members perform live over there. 20 seconds to go according to that. So I'm going to go to Yodobashi Akihabara. Maybe shoot one more video and that'll be it. So yes, let's go find this video capture card. So if you just look ahead in the opposite direction, when you've lost all motivation to go out and explore in the small shops, if my time limit is up, this is probably the biggest, probably the best single electronic shop in Japan. It's Yodobashi Camera in Akihabara. It's only actually been here for a few years. There used to be nothing like this on the side of the station. All the electronics is on the other side. And I must admit, as much as I like going around the sports shops, you can find anything in here. I'm going to go here and look for my car. And that's the station right there. It's super convenient. And it's a beautiful place to